Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in best practice, predefined content including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. Projects provides integrated drivers that help you model all project types, plan for individual employee and asset-related costs, expected revenues, as well as track project performance using prebuilt metrics. In planning, navigate to the Configure page. On the Configure page, you can enable strategic modeling, financials, workforce, capital, and projects. I'll configure projects. In Enable Features, select the types of projects you want to plan for and which predefined drivers, categories, and options you want to use. I'll start by enabling internal indirect projects. For project benefits, I'll select to track qualitative and quantitative financial and non-financial project benefits. For expense, I'll select driver-based employee labor rates. This will help to plan labor costs for projects. You can map dimensions to establish a relationship between a dimension in projects and a dimension in another module. You can use existing dimensions in multiple modules. For example, if you enable financials and later enable projects, you can take advantage of any existing dimensions that are common between the two. Use this feature so you don't have to rebuild a common dimension when you enable a new module. You can also define custom dimensions or rename dimensions. Review your selections, then proceed with the enable process. Enabling features takes a moment to complete. When a confirmation message displays that projects was enabled successfully, log off and log back on to see your changes. You can now access projects from the homepage. You can review project summary information, plan for project expenses, and conduct analysis on this dashboard. Notice that only two vertical tabs are shown because I only enabled indirect projects. Let's go back to the Configure page and see how we can incrementally enable more features. I'll enable contract project types, manage revenue using direct input and driver-based accounts, and enable direct input for expenses. After enabling more features, Project Summary now includes a dashboard for contract projects. I can also plan for both revenue and expense. Next, let's take a look at additional configuration options for projects. For projects, you can configure drivers, set project properties, load members, and exchange rates. I'll add entities by importing from a flat file. I'll verify the import process completed successfully in jobs. Next, I'll configure expense accounts. You can work with specific areas of the account hierarchy by selecting options from category and component. From the Actions menu, you can add a new account or import and export members. I'll import members into my application. You can add or load custom project properties. Since I only have one member to add, I can add it instead of importing. I'll name the property project category and assign it to the appropriate smart list. We'll be using this property to assign categories to our projects, such as information technology, new product development, digital transformation, and so on. Make sure to complete all required areas in the configuration, as well as sections needed by your organization. After performing configuration tasks, you must refresh the database to see the changes in your application. After configuring projects, you can start planning for your projects. Planners can begin adding projects, entering assumptions, and planning for revenue and expenses. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.